कॉन्फिडेंस है यार, तुम पोहे खाते हो थाली भर भर के, कहाँ क्या तुम? मेरे को शंका हुई, बांग्लादेश कहते हो?
मैं क्या कर सकता हूँ, ना जाने तो आनंद से हलवा जो है अरबी लफ्ज है, हिंदी का नहीं है, उर्दू का भी नहीं है। हाँ तुम लोग अरब हो गया है? फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर हलवा सामने रखा हुआ, उसको नमस्ते कर रहे हैं।
Good evening, you're watching To The Point. I'm Preeti Chaudhary. Well, it all started when the Bharatiya Janata Party's General Secretary, Kailash Vijayvargiya, sparked a massive controversy when he indulged in some food politics, claiming to have identified immigrants by their choice of food. Very humble, poha, possibly your breakfast dish. His comments sparked a rather distasteful political controversy. Here's the full report.
कौन से देश के यार, सिर्फ पोहे खाते हो थाली भर भर के, कहाँ क्या तुम? मेरे को शंका हुई मुझे, बांग्लादेश कहते हो?
The humble poha, a dish made of flattened rice, can indicate nationality, claims the BJP's Kailash Vijayvargiya. The BJP's Bengal in charge says he has identified labourers at his home as Bangladeshis after seeing them eat poha instead of rotis. Vijayvargiya made the statement at a seminar in Indore.
एक थाली के अंदर 6-7 मजदूर इतने सारे पोहे, मतलब कम से कम 10 प्लेट एक थाली भर के। मैंने अपने सर्वर को बताया, मुझे एक तो भाई इनको रोटी रोटी नहीं बने, उधर भी रोटी खाती नहीं, क्यों? उधर सब ये पोहे खाते हैं बस। मेरे को शंका हुई कि कौन से देश के यार, सिर्फ पोहे खाते हो थाली भर भर के, बांग्लादेश कहते हो?
The remark on poha has drawn the ire of the opposition.
पोहा तो मालवी व्यंजन है ना, है? और ये कैसे पहचान लिया कि वो बांग्लादेशी थे?
बयान आया सर आज।
अब वो आजकल वो थोड़े से विचलित हैं, जब से माफियाओं पर इंदौर में कार्रवाई हुई है, कैलाश जी बहुत विचलित हैं।
AIMIM chief Asaduddin Owaisi, who had earlier questioned the customary halwa ceremony before the printing of the union budget documents, took another jibe at the BJP. He tweeted saying labourers should not eat poha and instead eat halwa to be called Indians. As the row escalated, Union Minister Prakash Javadekar stepped in for some damage control. But former Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan has backed Kailash Vijayvargiya.
और आपको भी खिलाता हूँ, तो उसमें कोई मुद्दा नहीं।
वरिष्ठ नेता हैं, वो जो कहते हैं सोच समझ के कहते हैं।
पोहा इंसिडेंटली इज अ पॉपुलर फूड आइटम ऑफ मध्य प्रदेश, इट्स आल्सो अ फेवर्ड स्ट्रीट फूड सोल्ड इन सिटीज अक्रॉस इंडिया। नाउ द पुअर पोहा हैज आल्सो बिकम अ विक्टिम ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स। ब्यूरो रिपोर्ट, इंडिया टुडे।
I want to cut across to my colleague Himendra, who's joining us right now from Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. Himendra, you know, just take us through this bit of controversy, and importantly, take us through how, because when I was in Madhya Pradesh, Himendra, every breakfast, you know, covering the election this time, every time, you know, breakfast time was poha time.
Well, let me first tell you that poha is a staple diet in Madhya Pradesh, many parts of Madhya Pradesh, including Indore, where Kailash Vijayvargiya, the National General Secretary of Bharatiya Janata Party, during this pro-CAA seminar, raised this storm of sorts when he said that he could probably identify people by the way they ate poha as Bangladeshis. He reported that matter to the construction contractor, and thereafter those people stopped coming to him. Here I am at a poha stall in Bhopal, and as you can see right now at 8 p.m. in the evening, there is poha. Poha is being sold. People are having poha over here. And let me also take some ground comments from the people who actually eat poha. That is it possible? भैया आप बताइए, कैलाश विजयवर्गीय जी ने कहा कि पोहा खाने के तरीके से पहचान लिया, क्या ये संभव है कि खाने के तरीके से किसी की राष्ट्रीयता पहचानी जा सके? क्या भैया आप बताइए, क्या संभव है पोहा खाने के तरीके से पता लगाना कि आप बांग्लादेशी हिंदुस्तानी कहाँ के?
नो, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है। आप देखो, बहुत सारे लोग हैं जिनका एक अपना एक व्यू होता है, तो मैं नहीं मानता कि शायद पोहा खाने के तरीके से आप किसी को आइडेंटिफाई कर सकते हो। ये आई थिंक कैलाश विजयवर्गीय जी जो कहा है मैं उससे एग्री नहीं करता.
सो पीपल हु ईट पोहा डोंट एग्री विद कैलाश विजयवर्गीय व्हाट ही सेड, बट लेट मी आल्सो आस्क द मैन हु सेल्स पोहा ओवर हियर. भैया आप तो सुबह से लेकर शाम तक पोहा बेच रहे हो. भैया आप आगे एक मिनट आइए. सो लेट मी गेट यू द, आप सुबह से लेकर शाम तक पोहा बेच रहे हो.
हाँ.
Kailash Vijayvargiya nevertheless has drawn a lot of flak, and the Congress party has reacted, saying that if that was the case, why did he not report the matter to the police initially?
You know, Hemendra, my apologies on this show tonight to you for making you ask an absurd question like that. I apologize and thank you for joining us. I want to now cut across to our panelists this evening. I have Tom Vadakkan, Bharatiya Janata Party spokesperson, and I have Priyanka Chaturvedi, Shiv Sena spokesperson. Tom Vadakkan, you know, if Poha was the benchmark, then why the NRC? We should have just figured out who ate Poha.
Well, Preeti, the other day on a flight to Mumbai, I was served poha. I mean, which is very surprising. I think this is now, I think, a storm in a teacup, actually, because this is a non-issue. Whether he was referring to the nutritional value of poha is another issue. Whether he compared his rotis as more nutritious than his poha. These are issues that you need to address directly to Kailash ji and find out from him whether he had an angle to it. These laborers work so hard and they have to have nutritious food. So if he feels that, well, you know, poha is not so nutritious that they should have roti, well, there is a humanitarian issue to it. But yes, the political parties are at liberty, like Oasi mentioned the halwa, you know, and whether he was mentioning Karachi halwa was another issue. The point is, you can politicize and you can politicize till the cows come home. So let's get this straight. Our country has a good sense of humor, and I'm sure, Preeti, you are enjoying this. Because the very mention of poha, now I'm a South Indian, I like North Indian food. But my North Indian food friends like South Indian food. Now, how do you say and establish? I used to like pasta when I was in the Congress, and I'm sure Priyanka also loved pasta at that time. But times have changed now. We have our own favorite food.
So well, you know, Tom Vadakkan, you've tied
a real issue out of it.
With due respect, and my apologies to you as well as my apologies to Hemendra for making him ask those questions to the poha wala. My apologies to you as well that you have to be here and defend the indefensible. Now, you did tie yourself in knots when you said, Mr. Vadakkan, that you used to like pasta at that time when you were with the Congress. Now, sir, with that basis of that, do you not like pasta anymore? Because you've communalized pasta along with poha.
Preeti, you got a point there, and you think you cornered me. I love pasta, all right, but I'm not an Italian, I'm an Indian. So by the fact that I eat pasta, don't decide that I'm an Italian and love the Congress party. I love pasta as a dish. That's the difference.
But like, say, pasta might be an Italian dish, but Kailash Vijayvargiya, Tom Vadakkan, and I'll bring in Priyanka on this as well. Didn't really quite, we'll hear the soundbite again. I'd like you to hear it again. Because I really don't think, sir, you know, with due respect to the nutrition value of, you know, poha or not, that he meant it, whether or not it was being nutritious for what he termed as Bangladeshis. So we'll hear it again, but I want to cut across to Priyanka. Priyanka, much ado about nothing. This was supposedly a comment made in passing.
No, it cannot be a comment in the passé. And can I just say something? It would have been funny. It would have been a joke if it wasn't linked to something that is being seriously discussed across the nation right now, which is the CAA and NRC. What we are seeing is the othering of people who are eating foods which are from a different culture, which are from a different zones. And that is what is worrisome. I must share with Mr. Tom Vadakkan, and coincidentally we both share the same past, we are both from the Congress. But let me tell him one thing. I continue to enjoy poha as much as I enjoy pasta. In fact, I had pasta lunch today with a colleague of mine. So the point here is not about the food you eat. It's about how in your mind and in the narrow-mindedness of what we are framing and the policies that we are coming up with, that we are othering people who may not eat the food that we love to see them eat. And the worst part about this entire debate is that Mr. Kailash Vijayvargiya is a politician from Indore, and Indori poha is renowned across the nation, and Maharashtra has had fights with Madhya Pradesh on the kind of poha that is served. The Gujarat has its own version, and it's a well-known popular dish which is nutritious, not just in terms of taste, in terms of providing the nutrients that people need. So I think it's just so sad that you link it with a controversy which is raging across the nation right now, and the urgent need to label everyone as people who are outsiders and not Indians. This is the danger that I would want to highlight. Not the fun part of it, but the dangerous part of it. You're deciding, you're profiling people on the basis of what they eat, how they dress, what they speak, the language they speak, and where they're coming from. That is the scary part, and this is something we need to speak about rather than the controversy.
You know, Tom Baduka, now away from the humor of it as well, and you know, the reason is when you say that this was possibly a comment in passing, you know, it shouldn't be taken seriously, but why shouldn't it be taken seriously? You have somebody like Kailash Vijayvargiya, who is the general secretary of the party, who's directly linking a food habit to a particular nationality. That nationality is in question today, protests, you know, across the country. On the other hand, you have the former chief minister, sir, the former chief minister of the state of Madhya Pradesh, from which comes Kailash Vijayvargiya, say what this man or what this leader has said is absolutely right. Kuch soch samajh ke hi kaha hoga. I want you to listen to it, sir, and then come back to it.
पोहा खाने वाले की स्टाइल से वो समझ जा रहे हैं कि वो बांग्लादेशी है, बाहर के देश से आया है.
वरिष्ठ नेता हैं वो, जो कहते हैं सोच समझ के कहते
हैं. पोहा खाने वाले की स्टाइल से वो समझ जा रहे हैं कि वो बांग्लादेशी है, बाहर के देश से आया है.
वरिष्ठ नेता हैं वो, जो कहते हैं सोच समझ के कहते
हैं. टॉम बडकन, वरिष्ठ नेता हैं वो, कहते हैं सोच समझ के कहते हैं.
Preeti, I am not contesting the cerebral strength of Vijayvargiya. That is not my case. My case here is, poha is not patented by Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat or Rajasthan for that matter. It's something that is eaten. And he said that in the passing, and I think you're making a big issue out of it. This is not about profiling. Well, I see somebody eating rice, and I think he is either from Andhra, Tamil Nadu or Kerala. And I'm shocked that even Bengalis eat rice, Maharashtrians eat rice, Kashmiris eat rice. So there is no possibility of profiling on food. So let's dismiss this thought that you can profile anybody on the basis of food. He mentioned it, what context it was in, what was his thought process. He was talking about the nutritional value of poha as opposed to roti. These are things you have to address it to him for clarification. It is not for the political party to answer these questions, whether poha is more nutritious
but
or
sir,
roti is more.
You know, Tom,
these are issues
Mr.
just to be settled
maybe
by
you'd like to not
a nutrition
address
expert.
No, Mr. Vadakkan, maybe you'd like not to act, because you know I give you enough credit that you understood what he said. Now, maybe you'd like not to address it because possibly you don't agree with it. I can understand that. It's landed you in a difficult spot. But, sir, you and I both know he's not talking about nutrition. I'll play it again for your benefit, because he clearly says that who are these people who are eating so much poha? Are they Bangladeshis? Why are they not eating roti? Nowhere is nutrition mentioned. So is it that all Bangladeshis eat non-nutritious food, sir? Because then we are making a comment on the entire nationality
eating
of Bangladesh. Priyanka wants to come in. Priyanka, come in, and then I'll cut across back to Tom Vadakkan. Yes, Priyanka.
Again, I just like to say something here. As much as Mr. Vadakkan would want to dismiss this controversy, this becomes an important issue to discuss and debate. simply because at the back of what we have been seeing across the nation in terms of profiling, this becomes relevant. Whether about nutrition, etc., we can continue to debate and discuss it. It would have been a joke if we were talking about how Rasgulla wars have been fought between West Bengal and Odisha. This is not that the same thing. It is basically saying that there are rice-eating lovers who are coming from Bangladesh, who are building homes in our states and are continuing to survive because of whatever we are giving to them and the jobs we are giving to them. This is extremely unfortunate, and also I would again reiterate, at the back of the entire controversy that the nation is seeing, what Mr. Kailash Vijayvargiya, again, he's not some small-time party member who you can dismiss. He is someone who holds an important position in the scheme of things, also happens to be in charge of West Bengal, which is going to be seeing an election coming soon, which again has an entire Bangladesh perspective coming in. So I will not want to dismiss this, and this has to be debated, this has to be discussed, because this profiling of people has to be out there in the open and discussed honestly. Let's not make this funny, let's not make this about dismissive, because these are issues which are reigning right now in this nation. And everyone on the base of the clothes that they wear, the words that they speak are being judged. They're being judged that people are being told that they're paid money for protesting. People are being told that they are speaking on, in a similar voice because they belong to a particular section. So that is something that and this particular statement coming from him also has to be a part of this, because it tries to demean and undermine an entire protest. Okay. Which the
nation
has
seen
right
now. Priyanka, stay with me. Tom, Mr. Vadakkan, I'm going to come back to you. But I want you to hear now two reactions. I would play once again what Mr. Vijayvargiya said. Possibly you don't want to hear it, but I would play that for you. But before that, Mr. Vadakkan, I want you to hear what the Prime Minister told us. Now, Prime Minister Modi, right before elections 2019, we were in an interview with him. And we asked him what his life was, when he was a Pracharak with the RSS. So he opened up talking to us and said, what he really enjoyed doing was, one of the few things he enjoyed was to cook poha for breakfast every morning and eat it. Let's listen in and I'll come right back to you, Mr. Vadakkan.
4:30-5 baje uthna, pura daftar mein jhadu lagana, pota karna, fir sabke liye chai banana aur 5:20 ko sabko uthana, fir hamare yahan ek RSS mein pratah smaran hota hai. To pratah smaran hota tha, sabhi mahapurusha ka smaran karte hain, fir sabko chai parosta tha. उसके बाद शाखा चला जाता था, फिर आकर के सबके लिए नाश्ता बनाता था, तो पोहे वगैरह बनाना मुझे बहुत अच्छा आता है, सबको मैं खिलाता था।
Mr. Vadakkan, sorry for a little bit more embarrassment. पोहे बनाना बहुत अच्छा आता है Prime Minister को, that's what he says. Would you like to convey that to Mr. Vijayvargiya?
Nothing. Preeti, I'm not surprised, because I like my poha, and if the Prime Minister can cook it, that's wonderful. And I think that is an information you must tell Vijayvargiji that it is. Please watch out. It is Prime Minister who cooks it. So the point here is you're making a point to me, but the real point is to Vijayvargiji. Tell him that this. Through your channel, tell him that this was what the Prime Minister said. I admit that poha is a national dish in India. This has nothing to do with Bangladesh, because Bangladesh may be trying to import poha. I claim that poha is patented in India. So I there's no dispute about it. But I also question Oasis right about halwa, you know. He can catch diabetes if he is recommending halwa as a national dish. Karachi halwa is more dangerous because there's sugar content in it, you know, Preeti, is very extraordinary. So that being the situation, balance it out. Politicians will speak, election time. So I think you'll have to bear with it. There have been, they've talked about dishes, they've talked about clothes. These are issues during election, a lot of things are said. So let's not call it profiling, Preeti, because the minute you call it profiling, you're going into an area which is absolutely grey.
Mr. Vadakkan, you know, I do appreciate the fact that at least you've admitted, and very few, you know, spokespersons for the party admit that ask that person, possibly he's made a wrong statement. And you are in a position where you have to possibly defend the indefensible. Priyanka wants to come in. Yes, Priyanka.
What I find unfortunate is, okay, absolutely, I appreciate Mr. Wadakkan saying that we should ask the individual concerned who's made that comment. I would hold that accountable from anyone who holds a position of seniority in a political party, which is being right now in which is in a position right now of being accused of profiling people. So profiling is something which is real, which is happening, and which is being judged, and which is being certified by people who belong to a party which is currently in the government. The second thing is, if y'all do not agree with what Mr. Vijayvargiya has said, either we get him to withdraw that statement, or he's going to apologize for that statement, or some action is being taken. He's held accountable for that statement. Last but not the least, I would just want to...
I'm short of time, Priyanka. I just want to take that question to Tom Wadakkan. Mr. Wadakkan, shouldn't he retract his statement or at least give an apology then?
Sure.
I would only tell you that these are issues that I suggested that you, through your medium, if this could be communicated to him, that the Prime Minister prefers Poha and he cooks it. He said that on record. If that could be communicated to him, it will help. But let me tell you,
why should
Priyanka
they become the medium?
Right,
why can't the party speak within itself?
Profiling and all that. But we must remember that the Shiv Sena and the Congress were in alliance, you know, and I think the alliance is not totally off. So there are many things that when you make a charge, that profiling. Please check your conscience and find out from your party the Marathi, the effects of outsiders in Maharashtra that the Shiv Sena has maintained. Okay. So if that was not profiling, what is? Question
All right, okay.
is,
I need to,
everybody
okay, I need to close
ask
this
their
debate
own
because
conscience
we're also digressing,
of what exactly is profiling.
Okay. Appreciate you joining us. And thank you, Mr. Wadakkan, and thank you, Priyanka. But I'm going to leave this debate with once again, cutting across to what the Prime Minister told us. His views on Poha. He actually cooks it rather well. Thank you both for joining us.